characters are the lifeline, they're the centerpiece, they're how we access a story. Nice people with common sense do not make interesting characters, they only make good former spouses. Characters are about conflict and about interesting kind of twists and turns, not about being pleasant. Carl Jung, the psychologist, left us with so many of these archetypes, and they're convenient shorthands to tell our stories, because by using these archetypes in our stories, it allows us to quickly get the audience to associate with them, not only because we know people like this, but because we see a little bit of each of these characters in us. So in us is the child, in us is the mother, the witch, the devil, the wise old man. And we relate to those heavily because of that. We can also talk about it in terms of psychological disorders, obsessive fixations, general anxiety disorders, schizophrenia, which would be these characters. They describe things that we can relate to. And I'm exaggerating to make a point, but it's completely true. I mean, Pooh is really obsessive about his honey. So the meeting of two personalities is like a contact of two chemical substances. If there's any reaction at all, both are transformed. And that's another aspect of storytelling, is change. Look at these great characters. They don't exist solo, but Calvin and Hobbes exist together, and they love each other. And you can tell that by the way they move. These characters love each other, and they're simple. Characters have simple, distinct shapes in life. He's a square, he's a circle. These characters from Jungle Book, which just came out 50 years ago last week, if you colored those in silhouette, you would still know who those were, and you would be completely clear. That's not just an animation, that's in real life. This is an Annie Leibovitz photograph of the Olympic team from a few years ago. Look at the variety of sizes and shapes in these people. And they move differently, and they look differently. Characters have distinct colors. These are the Disney princesses. And you can pick out who they are. You know that Snow White and Ariel and Belle. And it's just their colors. There's no face. There's no body. It's just their colors, but that's distinct of who they are. Even their costumes can tell the color. As Belle in Beauty and the Beast falls in love with the Beast, the art director wanted to have her dress fall in love with him. So she starts out with this cool, blue, cold dress in the village at the beginning. And when she gets to the castle, the dress warms up. She's throwing snowballs, and she's wearing a red cape. And by the time she expresses her love for the Beast, she's in this beautiful, warm, hot, golden gown. So even her costume's telling the story. Characters move differently. Here, Alfred Hitchcock's telling an actress how to move on stage. And he can communicate that to her, but the two of them and their body weights and their sizes and shapes are different, and they move differently. They can't help but move differently. So we talk a lot about the pipe. We talk a lot about VR and AR and movies and techniques and diminished audience and all that stuff, and rightly so. That's our business, and we need to be aware of all those things. But too often we get hung up talking about just the pipe and not what's in it. So what's in it is everything, and what's in it is storytelling. And the things that, this is my idea of what we look for in storytelling. And I'm not a psychologist, I make cartoons for a living, so take it with a grain of salt. But this is what I think is what we're searching for, which is simple. We're searching for meaning in our lives, a sense of certainty, and a sense of belonging. Because without that meaning, our life is hopeless and chaotic. Without that certainty, we're full of doubt and uncertainty and anxiety and distrust. And without belonging, we're in fear of being abandoned and shunned and in solitude. So our characters are constantly searching for those, and the fundamental issues of our lives are taken up in our storytelling. Stories are how we share what it is to be human and get affirmation that our lives have meaning. This is Aristotle, and we use his structure, Aristotle's incline, a lot in Hollywood films, maybe too much. But that three-act structure that Aristotle came up with 2,000 years ago is still valid. So in brief, it's kind of act one, introduce your character and get him or her up a tree with an inciting incident. Act two, throw rocks at him, push him out onto a branch. And act three, let him down with an act of personal heroism against his worst fear. Again, storytelling is about our fears and overcoming them. So how do we do that? This is my personal process, which is create lots of stuff. When we start a movie, we fill a room with reference and artwork, and we organize it, and then we edit it. We take out the junk and leave what really, truly inspires us. Then we present the story to an audience. We previewed Lion King, I think, 11 times before we released it to an audience. And then when we show it, we weep openly in a bathroom stall. listen and adjust and repeat the last three as needed. This iterative process is really important. People ask, well, what makes Disney, what makes Pixar or animation in general so successful? And part of it is the iteration we can do. We can change our movies up to the last minute because our actors are always in their trailers and our sets are always built. Here's Lion King in three drawings. The first act, all of the first act is his dad is killed and his uncle frames him for murder. All of the second act is he grows up denying his past, he can't face it. All of the third act is he returns to face his worst fears, which are these guys. So that's the entire plot of Lion King, 100% in those three or four drawings. It's not much more complicated than that. Here's Wizard of Oz. Starting out at home, there's an inciting incident. They journey into the woods, and she comes home safe and changed. Return back to home safe and changed. Again, Kurt Vonnegut. Somebody gets into trouble, then gets out of it again. People love that story. They never get tired of it. That's not oversimplified. Somebody gets into trouble, then they get out again. Boy meets girl, they fall madly in love. Boy loses girl, and then they get out of it again. We love that story. And so we can keep it simple in our storytelling. And if we have 15 seconds to tell a story or 15 hours to tell a story on television, we can keep it simple. I was in a meeting once and the executive got so angry, he kind of blurted out, well, just tell me, what does he want and why can't he have it? And I thought, well, that's kind of profound. What does our character want? What is this story about? What does he want and why can't he have it? So when you're telling stories, something like this, Sword in the Stone, pull the sword and you're the next king. Everything in that movie is about that, the entire film. Or Save the Puppies. Or A Rat Dreams of Cooking. Or A Little Girl Adopts a Space Alien and Stops Intergalactic Assassins. It's a little more complicated. Or my favorite, transported to a surreal landscape, a young girl kills the first person she meets and then teams with three strangers to kill again. It can be simple. Empathy, building emotional engagement. We build physical engagement in VR and gaming and those kinds of things, which is brilliant, and I think the future is exciting in those places. But as important is to build emotional engagement. Here's a clip from a 75-year-old movie. It's about an elephant. It's not even about an elephant. It's a drawing of an elephant. See if you're engaged with this. That kind of emotional attachment is quick. That clip is under a minute long, and you're immediately with those characters. Iteration, we talked about briefly, but the failure of iteration is actually the success of the process. So Samuel Beckett said, ever tried, ever failed, no matter, try again, fail better. And in our story process, I had a drawing teacher once that said, you have 10,000 bad drawings in you, and the sooner you get them out, the sooner you get to the good stuff. And that's true about our stories. Fail fast, fail often. If you want to succeed faster, you have to increase the frequency of your failures.